and welcome to Kingdom One Life, where it's all about a kingdom perspective. I'm your host, Deborah Asbury. Today's program comes to you in part by JVC, Party Rentals and Event Hall, located in Lilburn, Georgia, where the best parties start here. Also by AE Fitness of Loganville, Georgia, owner-operator Alan Elliott. Get motivated, remain inspired, crush complacency. Today's episode is part two and a continuation of my conversation with Martina C. Young and Dexter Jones of Biz Up. They will share more entrepreneur insights from their individual book projects. So stay with us, we'll be right back. Since the age of 14, my guest today found strength in understanding people, defining their needs, and helping ignite passion within what she calls the hustle. She's a hustler and a dream activist who trains entrepreneurs to do the impossible. And William Dexter Jones has a deep understanding of sales management and data analyst. He is adept at streamlining processes, ensuring overall business health, and leveraging data to drive informed decision-making. Welcome back to Kingdom One Live, Martina C. Young. You know what, this is a tongue twister, and Dexter Jones, welcome back. Well, you guys have never gone anywhere,
but no,
we'll shake hands.
Yes.
And we'll start over again. Thank you guys for staying with me today. I really wanted our audience to hear more about what you all have going on.
Okay.
Biz Up is a great concept. I really love the way you are helping small and medium-sized businesses and also consulting some of our large corporations. Mm-hmm. And you've also put it in books.
Yes.
And so your book, we'll start with you, Dan.
Okay.
Now, your book is entitled Becoming the Boss.
The Entrepreneur's Guide to Becoming the Boss.
Entrepreneur's
and
Guide to
Boss
Becoming
is a
boss.
Business owner striving for success.
Okay.
It's a long title.
Yeah, but it's a necessary title.
It is a necessary title.
So what inspired you to write that book?
Oh, my gosh. So I'll just... You know, I don't know any other way to be but myself. So what really inspired me to do this book mm-hmm. was being out in the entrepreneurial field, dealing with other entrepreneurs or helping businesses to get started. Mm-hmm. And they just lacked tact. there's just a lot of things that at that particular time I was dealing with new clients coming in. And, you know, let's barter services. I didn't get in business to barter services. I have a chapter that says entrepreneurship is not let's make a deal.
I noticed that.
You know, we're in business. You get in business to make money and to provide, mm-hmm. you know, for your family. That's
yes.
initially what it is. It's getting into business so that you're not having to punch a clock. Because when you punch a clock, you're doing the same thing. You're providing for your family.
Right.
But those, you know, and then it was just a lot of different things within the entrepreneurial life through real situations. Mm-hmm. Every single situation in this book mm-hmm. actually happened. Had to change names, had to change it to protect people, but wherever it says I or me, that actually was
it
me,
was
and I'm being very transparent because I haven't always gotten it right.
Gotcha. But you know what? I like the way your table of contents actually says the entrepreneur's roadmap. So this is a roadmap. And you're right. I guess that's chapter two. Entrepreneurship is not let's make a deal.
That is correct.
And I can see that. And I'm probably guilty of it. It's kind of like you go into a small business. I, you know several individuals that have like, they have shops, mm-hmm. Clothing, boutiques. Mm-hmm. And so a lot of times they kind of set this precedence because they'll say, well, it costs this, but I'll give it to you for that.
Oh,
and I kind of understand why they do that because they feel like they have to do that.
And you don't have to do that because you can't do that. And you walk into a big box store. I say this on Facebook all the time. If you want me to negotiate mm-hmm. my prices,
right.
show me proof that you have walked into a big box store and taken your buggy and have negotiated the cost.
Right.
That's not going to happen.
It's no haggling.
They'll say, hey, leave the card here.
Right.
And well, if you take the card, you're going to jail.
Right. Well, you know, even the automotive industry, you know, that's an industry that's known for haggling.
Right.
But many of them have gone to that no haggle concept, whereas their prices are their prices.
That's correct.
Take it or leave it. Yeah.
Yes.
So I like that, and I think that's important. Especially when I look at some of the topics that you have here, it's really plain. And like you said, it's real life situations.
Yes.
Like never leave money on the table.
That part.
Are you playing or conducting business?
You know, one of the things, I get a lot of flack from this, but I'll just say, in are you playing or conducting business, is if you are a real business and you give me your business card, I should not see at a gmail.com. That's a Google.
Right.
That's a Google.
Okay, okay.
You should have your vanity domain.
Yeah.
So that, because I'm that person that if I get your business card and I see your email address,
right,
I'm gonna go to your website off of your email.
From corporate America, you don't work for, you know, Bank of America.
Correct.
And then you send an email, Yahoo, because whoever your customer is not going to take your business seriously, because
they're
gonna be like, well, this, I don't want my money in that bank. They got
That's
a Gmail
correct.
Account.
That's
a
correct.
Free email account.
Yes. and you know, and giving, you know, honor to where it is due and where I got the concept from. So as you can see, it has the scenarios of things that actually happen. And then there is a boss, business owner striving for success evaluation on how the situation should have been, it should have played out. So, and I got that from Rich Dad Poor Dad. Robert Kiyosaki did that. He was like, hey, this is the advice of my poor dad, this is my rich dad. And I kind of took that concept.
And I just want to mention that some of these topics are really hilarious. You cannot make a dead horse walk.
You cannot. That is business partnerships. Try to pick up a dead horse. That's where the dead partnership is.
Oh, my God. Never allow your dream to be corrupted.
Yes.
The team of one results in the power of none.
And that is about collaboration. A lot of people don't want to collaborate. But listen, there's enough money for everyone to eat. Everyone can buy groceries.
Right.
But if you're just, you know, me, myself, and I on everything,
right,
you know, you're either going to overwhelm yourself and the business,
right,
or you're going to implode.
I love what Dexter said during our pre-interview. He said that your partnership, after you guys came together, it's the first time that he had a business that was profitable, whereas you guys were able to really pay yourself a nice salary that you can sustain your lifestyles.
Yes.
And so that's what everyone is looking for.
Yes.
So we're going to go ahead and come to you, Dexter.
Oh, yeah.
So you did the SMB toolkit, which I'm assuming is a small business toolkit?
Yes, it's for small to medium-sized businesses. The entire purpose of it is to demystify the process of business ownership, of starting your business. The primary purpose is we go through a bunch of drills within the book, and as long as you go through the drills in their order, when you get to the end, you'll have a nice foundation. You still need to call us, but you'll have a really nice foundation and you're not out there just doing what you want to do.
Absolutely. Yes. I mean, and that's something really good for individuals, especially, would you say, individuals that are aspiring to become entrepreneurs, haven't actually taken that leap yet,
right,
just to kind of utilize your toolkit to get started?
Well, to get started, or if you've already started and you feel like something isn't in place properly. Mm-hmm. So the real purpose of the book was to get people who had heard pieces of information from multiple, like I heard it from a cousin, a friend of mine told me something, all those things, and like, hey, let's tighten it up a little bit and get to a place where we're all level. Then when you come to us for some services, like let's increase your website, let's get your marketing budget together, things like that.
Okay.
All those things are already in place.
Okay. Yes. I love it. I love it. And you know what? There's so many people. They said during the pandemic that there was a plethora of small businesses started. Now, I imagine, what does statistics say? Small businesses only last about...
Usually 2 years.
2 years. Yeah. If you make it to that 5 years, then you kind of have that smooth sailing.
Yes.
And
yes,
you guys are at 6 years, so that's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. And fortunately, we've, although our journey's diverse, I think my business started in 2001. So I'm in really year 23, but I never had someone that would hold me accountable. And I think that's kind of what makes the partnership work. She holds me accountable.
That marriage.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So the two have become one.
Yeah,
yours started in 01, and when did yours originally start?
2000. Well, this business, 2008. But I, like I said, I've had, that was my 17th business, but that's a whole nother conversation.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well, that's great.
Yes.
Well, you know what? This is a blessing, and that's what people need to pray for.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Good partnerships. And if you're going to do it alone, you got to be prayerful, and you got to listen with good reading out there, books. Of course, the Holy Bible is certainly a book that we all need to utilize for whatever business that or whatever profession that God has called us to.
Yes.
So we're going to go ahead and pause and take a break, and we'll be right back with more of Kingdom One Life. Stay with us.
Just as relationships evolve and grow, so should the relationship we have with God evolve and deepen. Pay attention to the little reminders God shares throughout the day. They are there for a reason. This devotion provides 52 reminders of God's love as He calls you into deeper relationship with Him. With a donation of $30 or more, you will receive A Year Without Pants by Terry King Hunt.
Welcome back to Kingdom One Live, where it's all about a kingdom perspective. We are here with our special guest, Martina C. Young, as well as Dexter Jones. They are the owners of Biz Up. And so before the break, you guys were, you know, just kind of enlightening us about your individual book projects. Mm-hmm. Was there anything specifically that, you know, maybe we didn't cover that you think would be important for our viewers to know about, you know, operating a small and medium-sized business?
You take this one, Martina.
Yeah, it was really important. So regarding the book, at the end of every chapter, there is, of course, work. I am an entrepreneur's trainer. I'm not a business coach. I'm an entrepreneur's trainer.
Okay.
So, of course, there's going to be work to do, because what I have found out from my own reading is sometimes you'll read and you may take a note here or there, but it's like, okay, great, you forget about it. But when we're asking questions directly about the business that you're starting or the business that you currently have, as it relates to the lesson that was taught in that chapter, it becomes more personable, and then you have action items. The one thing in our partnership that he annoys me about is he's always like, okay, what are the action items? Oh my gosh, can we just have a conversation without action items?
Okay.
But it is very, very important to have that.
Well, it sounds like that's what makes the partnership work.
Yes.
Again, you know, you got the information, and then you got to know how to apply it.
That's right. Correct.
Yep, exactly right. Exactly right.
And was there anything else that's part of the toolkit?
Yeah, I think At least as it was written, because this came from a random situation with me doing a speaking engagement. I think
it's, oh, really?
Yeah, I was just speaking out in Vegas one day, and all of it came to me, and I didn't make the book up. It came from, it's definitely, I won't say it was divine intervention, but certainly it was not Dexter's words.
It
was,
it came back to your remembrance. It's got to be a combination. Well, you know.
Yeah.
God, he's the one who gives us the ability to create wealth.
Right.
And
yes.
So we'll just go ahead and give him the glory for it, okay?
Yes. And I was just going to say, it was really important that for everything that we offer, that there's something that you are putting your hands to write to on the book. Mm-hmm. So you're constantly doing hands-on drills, work, no different than working out or any other thing that you need to practice.
Building that muscle as you build your business.
Mm-hmm. That's correct.
That is so wonderful. Well, you know what? We're going to switch gears.
Okay.
And we're going to do something just a little fun. We're going to see how much you guys are alike. So we're going to do the Be Enlightened lightning round.
All right.
So this is fast-paced, either or, this or that type of questions. Okay. And it can be a little chaotic because it's two of you. So just shout it out.
No problem.
I know you're a gentleman, but you don't have to wait on Martina.
Okay.
Just shout it out.
We're real competitive. we're built for this. Let's go.
Okay. So you ready? Let's jump right into it then. Coffee or tea?
Coffee.
Tea.
Pork or beef?
Beef.
Beef.
Italian food or Mexican food?
Italian.
Thanksgiving or Christmas?
Thanksgiving.
Beach or mountains?
Beach.
Mountains.
Cats or dogs?
Cats.
Dogs.
Sports cars or motorcycles?
Sports cars.
Yeah. Road trip or flying?
Flying.
Road trip.
Pastries or candy?
Neither.
Pastries.
I hear you on that one. And what is your superpower?
I am Wonder Woman.
I love the
Batman and Robin. I'm like, Justice League, because Wonder Woman could do all things.
Yes.
And I have been put in situations where I've had to do all things through Christ who has strengthened me. I live
Amen.
By Philippians.
And what's your superpower?
It's the ability to disarm. So I can go into any room, and I'm able to really connect and reach pretty much anyone in the room, regardless of where they were when they got there. So
what a unique ability.
Yes.
Okay, guys.
Comes in handy.
So let our viewers know again. I know you told them at the end of the last episode how they can reach you, but let our viewers know again, and I'm sure they can find information about your books, about you guys, and of course more information about Biz Up.
All right, so you can find us at bizup.me, and that's bizup.me. And all the information is there.
Go today.
Exactly.
Well. So, and I know if they go there, there's going to be information that they'll find that will just be able to help them. You know, you can't beat getting some free information just to help you, even if you're just thinking about, is this something I want to do?
Absolutely.
But thank you guys for joining me.
I have just enjoyed
our conversation.
I do.
And so next up, we're going to have our musical guest, Angela Monique. So stay with us. We'll be right back.
At Faith Shakers Collection, faith is not confined to Sundays. We're shaking up the scene with threads that shout beliefs loud and proud. From everyday casuals to Sunday best, The Face Shakers Collection's purpose is for people to find the perfect fit that reflects their inner fire. Face Shakers Collection, reflecting faith through wardrobe. We are on Instagram at Face Shakers Collection.
Hello, everyone. Back for a second song selection today. Our musical guest is a two-time survivor of open heart surgery as a child. And she has written about her transformation from religion to a relationship with Christ in her book, Moving Mountains, How I Learned to Love God's Way. She will be singing King of All Kings. So let's give it up for Angela Monique.
that created you and me. Lord, it is you that I believe and I receive. God, it is you that I believe and I receive as King of all kings.
Just as relationships evolve and grow, so should the relationship we have with God evolve and deepen. Pay attention to the little reminders God shares throughout the day. They are there for a reason. This devotion provides 52 reminders of God's love as He calls you into deeper relationship with Him. With a donation of $30 or more, you will receive A Year Without Pants by Terry King Hunt.
In closing, I want to say thank you to our special guest today, Martina C. Young and Dexter Jones, who are the owners of Biz Up, where they are helping small and medium-sized businesses become successful. Also to our musical guest, the phenomenal Angela Monique. Luke 6:31 is known as the Golden Rule, and it states, "Do unto others as you would have them do unto you." This is one of the most important biblical principles. It works if you work it. Make people first thing. Think of others first. Treat others like you want to be treated. Practice thoughtfulness. When you think of the customers, they will think of you. Many great businesses use this principle as the foundation of their organization. JCPenney used this principle as one of his primary principles to start and grow his business into a thriving corporation as we know it today, JCPenney's. So what are your thoughts? Feel free to weigh in on the discussions. Like us, subscribe to the YouTube channel and the Facebook page. Join us here weekly on Kingdom One Live, where it's all about a kingdom perspective. Thank you so much for watching. And until next time, love and blessings. We'll be right back.